Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji and this is the 7th video of the parametric design series. So far we learned about Dynamo, its interface and some of the interactions between Dynamo and Revit. We learned about how to create a grid and a set of circles in Dynamo and how to randomize the numbers. Today we're going to use a different method to create a pattern which is using an attractor. We're going to see what an attractor is, how it works, how we can relate it to our pattern, and we're going to use more math functions. Later on, we're going to use a 3D pattern, we're going to assign some thickness to our 2D patterns, and later we're going to try some patterns for vertical surfaces, as like for a facade design or an interior wall. By the end of this session, you should be able to create some patterns such as this one, or this one, or this one. First things first, you need to think about the algorithm. You need to plan the whole thing in your mind or on a piece of paper before you start. Basically, just like before, we have a grid, a set of points. We assigned a set of circles based on those points. What's new here is that if we consider this as a set of geometry, we're going to have a different geometry, which is one single point as an attractor point, and we're going to relate this set of circles to that attractor point and get the distance between the attractor point and the center point of each circle and relate that to the radius of the circles. Okay? So first we need to set up the grid. Second, we need to set up the attractor point. Third, we need to get the distance between the attractor point and the center points of the circle. Fourth, we're gonna define the radius of the circles based on that distance. Let's get back to Dynamo. We had this before, I'm not gonna repeat it. As you remember, we created a set of grids and we created a set of circles based on those grids. If you want to be able to follow the process later, it's not a bad idea to have some groups. So I'm going to group this part, the whole grid part. I'm going to select the nodes, right click on any of them, and go with create group, and this is going to be grid. Now see, if I move this, it will move only one node, but if I click somewhere around here and move it, it's going to move the whole group. Okay, so that was step one. We did it before. You know how to set up a grid and set up a set of circles based on those grids. The second level would be to create an attractor point. You can go with geometry, go to points, bring it from there, or just to be a little bit more advanced, let's just type point. We have point by coordinates here. I'm gonna use that. This is gonna be our point, and you see by default, it's on 0, 0, 0 over there. You can see it. I wanna rename it as point. I'm going to key point and add attractor. Just like before, you know that we can use some number sliders to define the location of the point by defining x, y, and z. So I'm going to bring a number slider. It can go from like 0 to 10 should be enough, or maybe 20. That's good, okay. I'm gonna name this as attractor X. So this will give me the X of the attractor point. I'm gonna copy and paste it, and the second one would be attractor Y. I'm gonna connect attractor x to x, attractor y to y. And now you see if I change these number sliders, the location of that point changes. Right? It's now here. So we have grid over there. We can also group these three items. Create group, and we're gonna name it as attractor. I'm gonna move it down here. Okay, so far so good. Now we have the circles there, and by default, the radius is 1. What we're gonna do is that we're gonna get the distance between the attractor point and the grid, and I wanna relate that distance to the radius here. Okay, so first we need to get the distance between these two groups. I'm gonna go with distance. And you see here, there's an option named distance to. I'm gonna bring that. And as you see, the inputs are two geometries. One geometry and the other geometry. One geometry is the points, the other geometry is the attractor point. Now what happens here is that we have 48 elements, actually 48 numbers, which give us the distance between each of the 48 points here and that one attractor point. Now we're going to relate this list of 48 numbers to the radius of the circles. We want the circles to be larger as the distance gets larger, and we want the circles to be smaller as they get close to the attractor point. So now if I assign this number, and you know wherever you see the word double in Dynamo, it means that it's a number. What happens if I just assign this double to the radius? You see, we are getting close, but the circles are too big. If I use a factor to make all these numbers a bit smaller and then assign it to the radius, it's going to look a little bit better. So how about I go to the math operators, and we are looking for division, or under the search you can just put a slash, bring this, put here. I want to divide this number by some other number, maybe 10. And as soon as I connect this, you can see we have a list of 48 numbers here again, but they are much smaller, and it makes more sense to consider these numbers as the radius of the points. Let me unpin these. So did you see what happened? We used the distance between the attractor point and the grid. We got the distance. We made that distance a little bit smaller by dividing that by a number bigger than 1, and we assigned it to the radius of the circles. Now if I go with a different number, such as 5, the radius is going to be different. The larger this number is because we are dividing that x by this number, the smaller the circles will be. So for instance, if I go by 10, it's going to be smaller. If I go by 15, they're going to be even smaller. The other factor controlling the pattern is the location of the attractor. So if I change the x or y of the attractor, you see based on where we have the point, the pattern will change. Notice that the attractor can be even outside the pattern and it will still work. The rest is easy. We can patch the circles to create a surface, and then you can import it back into Revit.